Pita, I saw you and Leonard Ellerby exchange some words. What happened there?
What happened with that?
Oh, yeah.
¿Qué pasó ahí?
It's because somebody tweet first. Somebody put up something like that. Mayweather again, saying that Canelo's contract, he made it in one night. He made what Canelo's contract right now, the 365 minutes, that he made it in one fight, and it's true.
So
but listen, Canelo's also 28 when he signed the contract. When Floyd was 28, he was barely having his first pay-per-views. He was making maybe, how much do you think he was making
four?
when he fought Gotti?
Four, I think four.
Like $4 million? Canelo's making 36, what is it, 36?
33
per fight. Some shit like, no,
36.5
per fight.
It's it goes up. It's a scale. You get paid the least in the beginning, the most in the end.
The average is 36.5. Okay. He made 365 in 10 fights. 36 per fight. So Floyd was 28 when he was fighting Gotti. That was his first pay-per-view. Made 4 or 5, maybe. Let's say the pay-per-view did good. He made $8 million. That's still like a fourth of what Canelo's making right now. So he really, you know.
No, you know, he didn't make that money. You know why? Because around the same time, Bob Arum offered him $8 million to fight Margarito. And he went and fought somebody else. But he didn't even make as much money there.
What would happen in that fight, him or Margarito?
Well, he probably would have beat Margarito, but it was too fucking risky.
Look, this guy says, like, Floyd got money, like, let it go. I know, we all know that he got money. Why does he keep putting other guys down to bring himself up? He did the same shit when Tank won the world title.
Yeah, his own fighter.
His fighter under his promotion. They brought Mayweather into the ring to talk after Tank won his world title, and they asked him about Tank winning his world title. He's the youngest. He was the youngest world champ at the time. He was like 22 years old when he won his title. And they asked Floyd, and Floyd's like, yeah, congrats, Tank did it at 22, this and that. I did it when I was 21 years old. I fought Chicanito Hernandez, who was, what does he have to bring himself into it?
He said, Chicanito was a better fighter than what
Chicanito, Chicanito, like basically saying, the guy I beat was better than the guy Tank beat, and I did it younger. Like, why do you have to put your own fighter down? Why do you have to say
that's
that?
His style.
Like right now, Canelo is the top guy. Who cares how much Floyd made? We all know he made a lot of money. That's his nickname, Money Mayweather. But you don't have to bring down like, oh God, I made what Canelo's making. When he was 28 years old.
What if Floyd's working on a comeback and he needs to rally up the attention?
Nah, he said it like right after he did an interview.
One thing I learned in boxing, what you say today does not apply for tomorrow. Am I right, Pita? People can say one thing today, but tomorrow's a whole nother story.
It's just kind of pathetic that, I mean, like, bro, you're retired. Like, he said it himself. He's like, I'm retired. I don't want to fight this and that. Then shut the fuck up. Let these guys do their thing.
Then let Canelo make his money.
By the way,
he made a very long fight. Who gives a fuck?
Okay, if he fights Conor and Khabib on the same night, does he win?
Yes, he fucks up those guys. Yeah.
Khabib's Mayweather.
Conor's not a boxer.
How about Oscar De La Hoya and Conor? Two rounds?
I think Oscar's
still fucking out.
Two rounds?
Yeah.
Would you watch it?
Yeah, of course I would.
That would be a big fight.
Then
Tarzan got here.
I like it. It has to be like that from now on. We're not going to be able to have that many fighters. We're not going to be able to...
Did you see? Oh, you didn't watch the UFC. You watched the UFC?
Yeah.
You streamed it illegally? It's okay. Don't need an answer. Don't incriminate yourself.
I had ESPN.
Oh, was it on the Plus?
Yeah.
How did they make it, Pita? How did they do with the three announcers? Each one had his own table. Where were the media sitting?
I don't know. Honestly, I didn't.
I looked at the media. Were like
the announcers. They were different tables.
Yeah, they're sitting separate.
And did you like
Cowboys,
it with no fans?
Cowboy
was the last free
fight. Cowboy was just like the Dallas Cowboys.
Yeah, Dallas Cowboy guy.
Hardy. He was like the first pay-per-view fighter. Yeah, he was the first pay-per-view. No, but what I was telling like Mike, I saw Mike yesterday, and he was asking me about the fight, and I told him that he was asking me about the no crowd, and I told him that it was a little...
Elsa!
I told him it was a little weird, but... Like, once the fight started, I mean, it's cool, it's like whatever, there's not a big difference. But the one thing that got pretty bad was like in the fifth round when Tony Ferguson was getting his ass kicked. Like, you could hear the punches and it got a little, you could say like disturbing. Like, you're like, fuck, like I wanted him to stop it because he was getting his ass kicked so bad. And you could hear every punch, you could hear the guys breathing. And like when Bryce Mitchell was fighting and he had a arm triangle on I forgot who he fought. You could hear the guy like taking deep ass breaths and like. So with the Tony Ferguson fight, the sound got a little like disturbing with how bad he was getting.
You called that fight. You called Gaethje to win. Why?
Because he's a bad motherfucker.
But so is Tony Ferguson, no?
No, he's not as gangster.
You know Tony, you used to train him.
I know him.
He's a good personality, he's a good dude.
I didn't follow, I don't follow, well, now I start to hear a little bit more because of this guy, but I never really followed it. But then when one of these guys said something like, Kukui Fugis is gonna haul, like, Kukui from fucking Ventura County? Yeah, well, you know? Yeah, we used to fucking train.
He won 12 fights in a row, right?
I had no idea he was already like.
Yeah, Robert, he's like a champion. Yeah.
Championship fight. I'm like, what the fuck, Kukui? I'm happy for him. That's cool.
By the way,
even though he lost, so what? When you're in those type of fights, you don't lose because he fucking made a lot of money.
Hopefully.
He'll come back. He'll still get big fights when he comes back.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.